The Indian External Affairs Minister has embarked on a 6-day tour of West Asia. Which countries will he be visiting? What's on agenda? Let's discuss over the next few minutes. The Foreign Minister's visit will include the first stop to be Bahrain. This will be his first visit to the country since assuming office. He is expected to land in a short while, and once there, he will be personally conveying condolences on behalf of the Indian government on the demise of Prince Khalifa bin Salman, the Prime Minister of Bahrain, who passed away on the 11th of November. And this will be followed by bilateral talks with the Bahraini leaders on regional and international issues of mutual interest. Remember, Bahrain is home to more than 350,000 Indians. The two sides have been working closely during this health crisis. Flights are operational between India and Bahrain under an air bubble arrangement. In fact, last year, Prime Minister Modi became the first ever Indian Prime Minister to visit Bahrain. The visit paved the way for greater trade collaboration between the two countries. Reports say the bilateral trade currently stands at approximately $1.3 billion. The External Affairs Minister's next stop will be the UAE. He is expected to leave the Sheikh Tim on Wednesday evening. In UAE, Ezra Shankar is scheduled to meet the Foreign Minister, Sheikh Abdullah bin Zayed Al Nahyan. According to the Ministry of External Affairs in India, the meeting will be aimed at taking forward bilateral cooperation under the Comprehensive Strategic Partnership. There will be discussions on ways for the Indian workers to resume their jobs in the UAE in the post-COVID-19 scenario. Remember, more than 3 million Indians live and work in the UAE. The two countries have maintained close high-level contacts during the pandemic. The hotlines between the foreign ministries have remained active. Moving on to the last leg of this tour, S. Jayashankar will travel to Seychelles. He is expected to meet the newly elected president of Seychelles. He will be presenting the Indian government's greetings to him. This will be followed by discussions on the priorities of the new government and ways to strengthen bilateral ties. Remember, India is currently involved in a strategic project in Seychelles. New Delhi is developing infrastructure at the Assumption Island, which will be used by both countries. S. Jayashankar will be holding an extensive meeting with the Foreign Minister of Seychelles over the same. We will be keeping a close eye on these engagements.